Welcome back. In the last video, we discussed about sending a custom event when people send 30 seconds on my site. Now, I'm going to show you how you can send more events when people send 30, 60, 90, 120. And I'll build more on that by taking into consideration what we've discussed in the previous lesson. So just go and build what we've learned in the early lesson. You see, we created one trigger in the last lesson called timer trigger. And this trigger will only fire once. And that trigger will only fire when you spend 30 seconds. Remember the limit, I gave it 1. But here what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it 5. Why I want to give it limit 5 is because I want to track how many people spend 30 seconds, 60 seconds, 90, 120 and 150. Earlier when the limit was 1, only when people come to my site and spend 30 seconds will be tracked. But I want to track all those people who spend some extra time also. That's why I give the limit as 5. Right, and I put the page URL to fire on all pages. Like I said in my previous lessons, some people, you know, only want to track about on their blog pages, so they can go give something called as a blog. But here I want to track all pages, so I choose dot star and all timers. 30 second, so I'll say 30 second, 60 second, 90 second, 120 second, 150 second. So I'll give a name. So we can easily remember 90 seconds, right? So now what I'm going to do is, once I create a trigger, remember every time people spend 30 seconds, GTM will push an event into data layer. GTM will push an event into data layer. So what I want to do is I want to show you a preview here. So you can understand what I'm really trying to explain. Yeah, so I go to preview here, you see. Still waiting for it. The debug is still not connected. At the right bottom, you see if the debug is connected. You see if the debug is connected. Yes, debug is connected with a blue circle. You see that is exactly the blue circle here. Page load, first one container, first one is gtm.js, which is container loads. You see, first event that GTM pushes in data layer is called GTM load, then gtm.dom, then window load. Now after 30 seconds, GTM will push one more event into data layer called gtm.timer. I'm waiting for the 30 seconds to complete. Now you see, once 30 seconds is completed, immediately another event is pushed called timer. Like that, 5 times event is pushed, each for 30 seconds, because I gave interval as 30 seconds, which is 30,000 milliseconds, and 5 times is the limit. You see, 30 seconds, you see, timer, 30 seconds over. No tag, we did not put the tag, I want to show you, see, timer. And what is the timer number? Because this is the first event in the timer, gtm.timer, first event. What is the timer interval? 30,000. You see, 30,000 is milliseconds. See, it is gtm.timer, I is capital. gtm.timer, event number 1. So now, if the event number is 2, what will happen? 30,000 into 2, which will be 60,000 milliseconds, which is nothing but 60 seconds. If you divide by 1,000, because milliseconds, right? 30,000 into 2, 60,000, divide by 1,000 is seconds, which is 6 seconds. Again, third time, it will be 3, right? So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to multiply both of them. gtm.event number, timer event number, gtm.timer interval. Right, when I multiply both of them and divide by 1,000, it will give me the seconds. And remember, the trigger will fire 5 times, 30, 60, 90, 120 and 150. So, and remember, these are data layer variables. So whenever a developer or whoever puts any value in data layer, GTM has a variable, inbuilt variable called data layer variable. You simply have to specify the key and system will get the value. So remember, I'm going to use gtm.timer interval, gtm.timer event number. So I'm going to create two variables here. Go to gtm here. You see, another event is pushed. This time the number will be 3. Interval will be same, 30,000 milliseconds. Now you see, I go to variables. When I go to variables, I'm creating 3 data layer variables. In fact, I've already created 3 data layer variables. I gave the name as gtm.timer event number. You see, DLV timer event number, and what is the name in data layer? You see, gtm.timer event number. This exact thing I copied and I put it here because I want to read the value. What value I want to read? I want to read if it's 2, if it's 3, if it's 4, if it's 1, right? So I created one data layer variable, right? Data layer variable you select, right? Second, I created one more data layer variable called gtm timer interval. Timer interval is 30,000 seconds, which is already there. So I'm trying to read that value from the data layer, gtm.timer interval, I is capital. You see data layer variable. Where do you see data layer variable? If you ask me, you simply go to edit, you have data layer variable here. So I've already created them. So now what I'm going to do is, after, you know, creating those two variables will listen from the data layer whenever the timer event is pushed. If the timer event is pushed, not pushed, there'll be nothing in the data layer. You see, if I go to window load, gtm timer event is pushed here. But if I go to window layer prior to the push, If you go to these variables, you see, undefined, because there's no value. But if I go to timer, the values are red. Why the values are red? Because there was an event that was pushed into data layer by GTM. I hope you understand. So I've created two and I want to multiply them. So what I have done is I created one custom JavaScript code. And simple, I wrote a small function, I return. Return is this data layer value, which is what value? The timer number, and into the timer interval. Divide by 1000. When I divide by 1000, it will give me seconds. So that value will be saved in this custom JavaScript variable. So custom JavaScript is like I'm writing a custom JavaScript. I write a function and I return the value that I want in seconds. And then I go to the tag here. You see, I'm going to go to the tag and I'm going to put these values in the tag and send this information to Facebook. You see what I'm going to do. You see, I'm creating a new tag. Time spent event tag Facebook. Here, remember, because this is a custom event, we always use a syntax called LBQ track. Then I'll use the name of the event as time spent. Earlier we were only sending seconds. Remember, we were only sending seconds, but now I want to send the event as time spent. Earlier we were not sending any custom data, right? Custom data you want to send with event, you always send it in the objects, key value pair. Here I'm sending an object now. You see, I'm sending an object now. So here I'll say seconds and I will put that CJS, which is a custom JavaScript function that we wrote, which will return the value by multiplying the event number and the interval, divide by 1000. You see, and then I can even put something called page, which page people scrolled. This is a built-in variable, so I choose something called page path. I don't want to go with all URL. So I close the object here. Once I close the object, I can see. Second CJS, I'm sending two values. And remember, this has to fire after the Facebook pixel is fired. So where is the pixel? Pixel initialization. Remember the small option called once per event. I want this to fire every event. If I say once per page, even that event fire 5 times, it will only fire once because it is only fired once per page. But here I want to fire 30, 60, 90, not once per page, 30, every time that happens. So once per event and I save it. Oh, I have to create a track. Okay, add a trigger. The trigger that I wanted to add is 60, this one, right? This we created already. Now when I go save, now let's see what happens. Earlier I was sending only one event called 30 seconds. Now I change the name of the event as time spent. But along with time spent, I'm spending extra values in the object saying second, 30, 60, 90. You see what happens live. It is getting refreshed. Debug connected. Now you see, window load, GTM, the values of GTM dot, you see, event number is undefined, timer is undefined, CJS is also undefined. Why? Because the event is not pushed into data layer. Once the event is pushed into data layer variables will capture the value, CJS will multiply both of them and will return the value. Those values of data layer and CJS I am putting in the tag. So wait for 30 seconds to complete. You see, now the event is pushed. The moment event is pushed, the values become available in data layer. Once the values become available in data layer, at this point, you see, CJS is null and they are undefined. But the moment you come to timer, you see CJS is 30, timer is 1, this is 1. Now if you go to the Facebook, you see page view was already sent. Apart from that, page view time is spent. And see, the page is home page and the seconds that you spent is 30 seconds. So when this data is sent to Facebook, I can go to Facebook and there I create a custom audience of only those people who triggered an event called time spent. But not just time spent, anybody who triggered time spent. No. I want only those users who triggered this event called time spent and spent seconds, which is 60 or 90. Because we know another 30 seconds, you see, another 30 seconds, another event is pushed with 60 seconds. How do you know that? You see, 30 seconds, 60 seconds. If you see 60 value. Why? Because multiplied 30,000 into 2 divided by 1,000 will be 60. And that 60 is stored in CJS. And this CJS is what I am putting it in the tag. Remember, this CJS is what I am putting in the tag. You see, another event is fired. Another event is fired. You see, another event is fired because 90 seconds. And then I can go back to Facebook and create custom audiences based on this. I hope you understand. This is very, very important. If you have a long website where people really spend, if you want to track the user engagement, scroll depth is one, time tracking is one. You got to make sure that you implement them. And based on this, you create custom audiences and then remarket with an offer and drive them to a landing page and drive them into the conversion bucket. Thank you so much. And I will see you in the next video.